gathered here today in the sight of God, family and friends, to join Brian and Morgan in the holy bonds of marriage, which was instituted by God and blessed by Jesus Christ, because it represents the union which exists between Christ and His holy church. Because marriage is a holy estate, it is not to be entered into without understanding, but with prayer and with the awareness of the presence of God. So today we humbly pray to our Heavenly Father to look lovingly on this couple and grant them the fulfillment and desires of their hearts. May Morgan be a good wife and Brian a good husband, so they both will always be faithfully in love with each other, caring for their home and living in peace and goodwill all the days of their lives. A reading from the book of Genesis. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I'll provide a partner for him." And so the Lord God put Adam to sleep. And while he slept, God took one of his ribs and closed the flesh over its place. The Lord God then built up the rib, which he had taken of man, created a woman and brought it to Adam. When Adam saw her, he exclaimed, "Now this at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. Therefore, man shall leave his father and his mother, and woman shall leave her home, and the two shall unite and be as one." Brian and Morgan, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? I, Brian, take you, Morgan, for my lawful wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part. I, Morgan, take you, Brian, for my lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part. I also promise to cook dinner every night.
That's what Sean's
for. Let us know that no individual brings anything into this life. We come into the world bare, and we can take nothing with us at death. All that we have is but borrowed. The only thing that we truly own is our individual lives. This, then, is the only gift that we can truly give. With this in mind, what tokens of devotion do you offer each other? I hold in my hand two beautiful rings, symbolic of a binding contract, to be given and received as bonds of never-ending love, friendship, and devotion. They are the circles of life, and they are the circles of love. The perfect circle of a ring symbolizes eternity, while gold symbolizes all that is pure and holy. as you give these rings to each other, our prayer is that your love for each other will be as eternal and everlasting as these rings. May these rings be blessed as a symbol of this affection and unity. And may they always be a reminder that you have chosen above all others, each other, as husband and wife from this day forward. With this ring I be wed, and because God brought us together, I gladly give my life to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. With this ring I be wed, and because God brought us together, I gladly give my life to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Before Brian and Morgan are united as husband and wife, let us all pray together as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. According to God's word, and the completion of this marriage ceremony, we have witnessed a miracle. Two physical beings have become one spiritual being in the holy bonds of matrimony. They will continue to maintain their identity as two separate individuals, but in God's sight, they are one flesh. This will be portrayed in the lighting of the unity candle. Because Brian and Morgan have taken these vows before God and have pledged themselves to each other, having promised to show the world that they belong together by giving and receiving rings, I declare that you are husband and wife. What God has put together, let no one put asunder. Mr. Brian, you may now kiss your lovely bride. It gives me great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Brian Higley.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. The dinner is ready. If everybody would like to serve themselves and help themselves their dinner, a lot of bride, bridal
love
party.
And marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. This, I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. An institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry, and they will say it's elementary. Try, try, try to separate them. It's an institute.